Hi guys, this is Captain Spencer Clark with Breaking Bass Guide Service here. I was going to give you guys a fishing report. I haven't done one of these in a little bit. I was going to talk about some of the things that have been working for me the past week down here at Table Rock Lake. The weather's starting to get better. More people are starting to come down here to Branson. And as a fishing guide, it's starting to get a little bit busier. We're kind of getting to that peak time of the year where people are wanting to get outside and do a lot more since we're getting better weather down here. Just wanted to give you guys a quick run through some of the baits though that have been working this past week. If you can find shad, whether it be on some of the main lake points or back in a pocket, there's a lot of fish right now down at Table Rock Lake that are making their way into the spawning pockets. If you can find like pea gravel pockets with a little bit of timber in them, fish are really starting to get into the center of those pockets, especially if you can find bait. Finding bait has been the key the past weekend. Found a couple of really good schools of fish that were keyed up on bait fish. If you can find that situation, you can get right in a hurry. When I'm finding bait and bass below them, what I'm doing to catch them is I'm just throwing an Alabama rig still. The water is 52 to 54 degrees in the dam area, and they're still eating these Alabama rigs. Some of the other baits that I'm using on these fish, they don't eat the Alabama rig. A couple other baits that you can throw to catch some fish are just a big old white spinnerbait. This is just an E-Factor spinnerbait. This is a 3/4 ounce one. This has been working really good, surprisingly, out in open water. I've been catching a lot of suspended fish on this big blade. Another one I've been using is just a little white 3/8 ounce War Eagle spinnerbait. I've been catching a lot of fish on this. The whole key is you want to get it just below those shad and then keep that bait moving at a pretty good pace to where you kind of want that blade just to sneak up on them, and they'll hammer it. The other thing too that I've been mixing up is a little bit is one of these chatterbaits. Sometimes it won't hit a spinnerbait for whatever reason. They like the chatterbait. Really sticking to like your shad patterns though, like your whites for the most part. And then if you fish Table Rock Lake quite a bit, you can never leave home without one of these little 2.8 swim baits. This is the new swim bait the Bass Pro Shops came out with. And I'm just matching that up on just a 1/4 ounce head like that. Sometimes it takes a little bit more of a finesse approach to get these fish to bite. I like to throw this on like 6-pound test. Been catching a lot of big smallmouth on this lately if I can find them grouped up by the shad. And another bait too that you can't leave home without is just a smoked grub. This has been working really good too on those more isolated fish. If you can't get them to hit the following baits, I can come through and usually pick off a couple more after they quit biting the Alabama rig, or they quit biting, you know, say a spinner bait or something like that. I can catch a few more on that. If you can't find shad and you actually got to go fishing, looking for them and covering water, a couple things that I've been doing is I've been throwing a spinner bait. Just fishing windy secondary points, just kind of windy secondary timbered pea gravel points. Those seem to be working best, especially if they've been a little bit flatter. A little bit more like a flatter point has been working better for me the past, I'd say about 2 weeks or so. And I've been throwing that spinnerbait, also been throwing a rock crawler around, catching some fish on this. It seems that the rock crawler bite for me has been a lot better in the afternoon, and the later the better. You know, once you get past like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, they really start slamming a crankbait pretty good, as long as you got a little bit of wind. This Phantom Green's been working real good. Actually, I've been catching a lot of my better fish just on this color here, this red one with like a green back. I've been catching some decent fish the past week here throwing this color. It seems like they're preferring this a little bit more over the usual one I like to throw, which is this Phantom Green. The rock crawler bite though it hasn't been as good as it was last year. Still catching some fish on it, but it's a little bit like more hit or miss, and it seems like you gotta have the right time of day for that to be happening. But anyways guys, that's some of the baits that I've been using down here at Table Rock Lake, and some of the ways I've been fishing them to catch a lot of fish. Something else that I wanted to show you guys is a rod here from Cass King. They're one of my sponsors. This is their Speed Demon rod, the 7'3" bladed jig rod. This rod is awesome for throwing one of these Spro rock crawlers. If you're looking for a rod to throw these kind of crankbaits, check this out. One of my buddies, it's also on Cass King, told me about this rod. And I've been having really good luck with keeping fish hooked up and catching a lot of fish using a crankbait on this. And I just paired up with one of these new Cass King Mega Jaws Elite reels. Been really happy with that reel that they came out with. It's been working really, really good. So just something to check out if you're in the market for a good crankbait rod. Crankbait fishing is something that I really like to do a lot of, and I feel that I can speak for that being a really good rod for throwing, like say like a wiggle wart or like a rock crawler. Been having really good luck with it. Check it out if you're interested in getting a crankbait rod. Well, anyways, until next time, guys, take it easy. If you're coming out of Table Rock Lake, need to hire a guide, give me a shout. Breaking Bass Guide Service, 314-562-3332. Love to get you out on the water. Until next time, guys, good luck and good fishing.
When it comes to hitching the boat up, backing down the ramp in my old truck, to find a bunch of logs, to catch a bunch of hogs, yeah, I rode the